Hi, everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. This is just a quick reminder, we're still running the SAP Developer Challenge for the month of July, and it's all about the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model. We are currently in week 3 of the challenge, and we just introduced custom logic with event handlers. If you haven't started with the challenge, that's not a problem at all. You can always catch up. And if you have never worked with CAP before, that's also not a problem. We give step-by-step guidance, so it's very beginner-friendly. And while we're on the topic of CAP, the reCAP conference happened a couple of weeks ago, and the recordings are now available online. So if you didn't have the chance to attend in person, you can now still consume the content. That's pretty cool. The links are in the description. All right, hope to see you soon. Bye.
Hey folks, Rich Hauman here. Hope everyone is having a great summer so far, but if you're not, you might want to check out some of the ABAP Cloud webcasts hosted by ASUG and presented by development experts from SAP. Tammy Palace, one of the prominent community members and ASUG volunteers, posted a blog post last month outlining the webcast sessions to be offered. We are right in the middle of the webcast series right now, with just two more to go. On July 27th, Frank Jentsch will present on SAP BTP ABAP environment, what's new and outlook. And then on August 2nd, Olga Dolinskaja will present on custom code adaptation to SAP S/4HANA and ABAP Cloud. So if you are an ASUG member, make sure to check out Tammy's blog post and register for the remaining webcasts today. In other news, last week, Thomas Fiedler tweeted about a new influence channel for ABAP API requests for SAP S/4HANA private cloud customers. We all know that it's important to use standard APIs when accessing data in ABAP Cloud, but what if there's no released API for your purposes? Now you can request to have those APIs created and released by SAP. Just head over to the page which Thomas had tweeted about and add your request. And finally, our friend Olga from ABAP Product Management has posted a new blog post about the usage of ABAP Test Cockpit in the SAP S/4HANA Cloud Public Edition. ATC is an essential tool for the quality assurance of your custom code. So while developing ABAP code in SAP S/4HANA Cloud Public Edition, you should have a very good understanding of how to use ATC for your cloud developments. Olga's blog post outlines everything you need to know about getting started with ATC and how it can help developers write cloud-ready, upgrade-stable ABAP code.
Hey, Srinit. I heard there's some interesting news in integration suite. Can you give more info?
Yes, Shilpa. There is a new graph functionality, which is an innovative capability of API management that is part of it, the SAP integration suite. It has been released for general availability after a rigorous 6 months beta program with SAP customers and partners.
How does graph functionality work?
Graph allows you to access data from SAP and custom systems through a semantically connected data graph.
So this might be exciting for developers, especially considering low or no code and integration experts to consume APIs in a much simpler and efficient way, right?
Yes, you're right. Developers can now access a single and unified API that supports powerful data graph query languages such as OData V4 or GraphQL. We can now focus on the data without worrying about the underlying landscape complexity.
Interesting. Where can I get more info on this?
Piyush explains the benefits of graph functionality from both enterprise IT and developers perspective in his new blog. You can find the link to his blog in the description below.